Would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away?
Does it worry to be alone?
How do I feel at the end of the day? I get by with a little help from my friends.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stands a real blade of grass. Be careful as you pass. Move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start.
Sort of.
Name three things that happened in the 1970s.
That's like a trick question, right?
I'll give you 1 minute.
Man, I haven't heard this song since college, you know?
Eat me, Phil.
Okay.
Give up.
That wasn't a minute.
Come on.
Great bass line.
Let's go. Do it.
Watergate. And. Oh, the Sex Pistols. And did I say Watergate?
Oh, rest my case.
Oh, Giant Leap for Man.
Oh, hang it up, Don. You're losing it.
And did I say Watergate?
Your mind is going, Don.
The 1970s.
Oh, you're riding on the vine. Well, I'm having fun.
Yeah, me too.
I know you are. We live in thrilling days, Don.
We do.
And I think that's swell.
I do too.
I know you do. You're an agreeable guy. And I've been meaning to tell you this, really. If someone came up to me and asked, now this Don fellow, what's he all about? I'd have to tell him, darn it, Don. Don is an agreeable guy.
I'd go along with that.
Would you go along with the toast?
By all means.
To you, Don, for being the postmodern kind of nut that you are.
Thanks, Jack.
To Phil, a great guy in spite of some desperate handicaps.
Okay!
And to me, for being perfect.
Oh, not easy.
And Don, to our times together, to campus cut-ups, to wasted potential.
Feels like years.
It has been years.
We're getting old.
Don, to our parents, to the dream they called America, to the big kidder upstairs,
the ladies.
Oh, Don, a toast, a very special toast to the ladies.
Oh, my.
Yes, indeed, because where would we be without them?
We'd be nowhere.
We wouldn't be here.
We wouldn't even exist.
We would not.
It's a sobering thought.
It's food for thought.
It's a thought to think.
Well, no sense in blaming them for it now.
Yeah, it's a dead issue.
It's all said and done, because when it comes right down to it...
Man, I love this part!
A man!
Is a man!
He is a man!
By any other name!
He still smells!
Amen!
Goddamn!
Goddamn shit!
Sucking shit!
Goddamn shit eating scumbag assholes!
Woo!
Woo! You know, you never have this kind of a talk with a woman.
No, you wouldn't. I want you to remember this, Don, when you're old and pissing in your daybed. Remember who brought you out of the jungle and shaved off your fur.
It was you, Master. You teach Don to walk like man.
You better be grateful. Here. Finish that off. Come on. Come on. What are you smiling about?
No, I was just thinking.
Uh-huh.
You know, I used to want to be an astronaut. Be up there in the quiet. Walter Cronkite talking about me to millions of people, and I wouldn't have to listen.
So?
So, I still want to be an astronaut.
Well, maybe we will be done. But even if you were, you'd still have to get out of bed in the morning.
Yeah.
Man, Emerson, Lake, and Palmer, whatever happened to those guys?
They all died horribly, Phil, in a bus crash.
They did? That's really depressing.
I thought it might be. Well, gentlemen, has anyone had a good fuck lately?
Does masturbation count? There you are.
Yes.
And here I am.
Yes.
Here we are, both of us together.
Talking.
Right here in the same room.
It's pretty amazing. Enjoying the party?
Oh, yes, certainly. Yes, yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Well, no.
Oh.
I mean, not in a larger sense.
Well, why did you come?
I was invited. I mean, Jack invited me.
And you do everything Jack says?
No, why? He's my friend. He's my oldest friend. But you look great tonight, Karen.
Thanks.
No, really, just fabulous.
You look good.
No.
Really, you do.
No, I don't.
Really, you do.
Do I?
What do you want, Phil?
Well, I don't want anything, just to, you know, say hello.
Hello.
Yes. Well, that's lovely what you have on. What is it?
A dress?
I've always appreciated your sense of humor, Karen.
What do you want? We're almost done.
What was all that about?
What?
That guy.
I don't know.
I mean, you seem pretty familiar with him.
Are you feeling okay?
Me? Oh, sure. Yeah. Doing good. Doing really, 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 really great. Just fine. I've got my own partition now over at the office. They set up one of those, like, so that's really good. I'm going to the spa a lot, trying to work out. I can't use the machines, though, because of my back. But I do love the jacuzzi. Strange, I actually fell asleep in it, you know, the whirlpool. When I woke up, I had this incredible headache. I mean, it would not go away. I felt this thing, like, right here, like the size of a peach pit. I went for a blood test. You know, I was convinced I mean, you hear all the stuff now, the way it's spreading? I'm not, but I was sure I had it.
Had what?
It, you know.
And?
Oh, I didn't. So, anyway, it's funny we both turned up here tonight. I mean, because I've been thinking, or I've been wondering. I mean, it's been about a month since I last spoke to you, and I was just wondering if we were still, you know, seeing each other.
Seeing each other?
Yes.
No.
All right. That's fair.
Well, you weren't never seeing each other, Phil.
Well, I don't mean like actually seeing each other.
We slept together once.
Hey, twice.
You left before I woke up.
Okay, yeah, but everybody does that.
And you never called.
Now, about that. Well, you see, I was in a very bad kind of situation, and as much as I wanted to, and I did very, 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 very much.
What do you want?
I just want another shot at it.
At what?
At you, to get to know you.
I'm not worth the effort, Phil.
You're seeing someone else, aren't you?
That's got nothing to do with it.
Oh, but you are seeing someone else.
I'm not actually seeing
someone. No. It's fine. I get it. Early bird and all that stuff. I'm fine. It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm fine.
It's got nothing to do with you, Phil. There's just some things I have to work through, but I like you. I do. You're a wonderful person.
Well, you're a wonderful person too, Karen.
Well, so are you, Phil.
That's right. We both are. Wait, listen to this. This guy at my office, he's got this cabin upstate. He never uses it. It's on the edge of this beautiful freshwater lake. Why don't we go there? Just the two of us. We relax, get out of the city, do some straight thinking. What do you say?
No.
Is it because this guy you're seeing?
I'm not actually seeing someone, but...
Well, then what is it?
It's just... It's not a good idea.
It's not?
No. Not at all. You're touching my breasts, Phil.
I think about you a lot, Karen.
You do?
Yeah, you know, at work, the laundromat, the shower, places like that. I mean that in a very positive sense.
I'm not worth it, really.
Come on, it's just 2 days out of your life. You know, this could turn out to be something really special. It'll be over before you know it.
You're making this very difficult.
I'm making it incredibly easy. Just come to the country with me.
Phil.
Please, come.
Phil, please.
I'm just asking for a chance.
No! No! My life is a real big mess, okay? And I read that by the time you're 5, you've already developed the major patterns for the rest of your life. I mean, whether you're basically going to be happy, a fireman, a lesbian, whatever... And of course, it's not fair because nobody tells a little kid anything about that, but that's the way it is. So I've been thinking about this a lot lately, and it occurs to me that somewhere along the line, I screwed up really bad. I made a poor choice about something, and now there is nothing I can do to change it.
I think I love you.
You haven't even been listening!
Of course I was! You were talking about your childhood, right? I love you!
No, Phil! I'm very flattered by
you! I'm not saying it to flatter you, Karen! I'm not talking about your drapes or something! I'm talking about this very real and undeniable feeling that I have for you. So, you're not happy. I think I can sense that from what you just told me. But nobody's happy! That's the way it's supposed to be! Do you think I'm happy? I'm not happy! I'm miserable!
I am too!
I know you are. That's why I feel so close to you. Karen, I can make you happy, and you can make me happy. We can help each other.
You just said that nobody is happy.
Well, I didn't mean that. I'm so crazy when I'm with you, I don't know what I'm saying. I love you.
No, please.
Please, I'm sick with needing you. It's an actual disease. I'm all swollen and rotten on the inside, and my brain is decomposing because of you.
What's wrong with you, Phil?
I'm dying without you, Karen. Has anyone ever told you anything like that, ever?
No, never.
Because no one has ever loved you as much as I do. Jesus, Karen, help me.
Excuse me, I...
What? What is it?
Well, my coat?
In a minute.
Listen, I've been waiting out
Why
there.
Why don't you just go away? I love you.
For how long?
Until I'm in my grave. Longer, forever.
No. How long would we have to be away for?
As long as you want. We don't even have to come back.
I was thinking just the weekend.
Yeah, the weekend. A day, an hour, a single second.
I have pasta class on Monday nights.
Great. Fabulous.
know, Phil. It's not that I don't want to.
If you want to, just say yes. Don't worry about the rest.
I can't.
Then just say maybe.
If I say maybe, you'll think I'm saying yes.
I won't. I promise. I'm very clear on maybe. Please, Karen, just give me a crumb. Throw me a line.
Let me think about it. I don't know. I'd have to... I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe. Maybe. Oh, thank you so much, Karen. You will not regret this. I'm crazy about you. You know that, right?
I'm not worth it, Phil. Really.
This is the happiest day of my life.
Look, I... Look, I just want my coat. Sorry. Are you?
Come on, let's go back to the party.
In a minute.
You're not coming?
You go ahead.
Wait, is everything okay?
Please stay away. Look, I'm sorry. God, I hate myself so much.
Wait, Carrie. Ah, shit. Shit, shit, shit.
Interesting girl. I mean, in her own sort of way.
Huh?
Nothing. Personality-wise, you know.
How would you know?
Well, she was my date.
Oh.
But not my type, you know? A little too high-strung. You know, I got better things to do anyway.
Well, we're in love.
You and her?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, you gonna throw me some cab fare or what?
Oh, come on.
Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice. Cause I speak of the pompousness of love. Cause I'm a picker, I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun. I'm a joker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. I get my loving on the run.
Running, huh? Hey! Out doing some running? Excuse me.
What?
I'm talking to you.
Yes?
I asked you a question.
What?
What's it for?
Huh?
The race.
We're jogging against apartheid.
Really?
No, of course not.
Oh. Interesting people, the Boers, don't you think?
I wouldn't know.
Is something wrong?
I'm going to die.
You should catch your breath.
What I'm trying to do.
May I? Ah, yes. Question authority.
That's what it says.
You know, excuse me, that's a bad place for a button. It can restrict your circulation. Should I take it off?
Where'd you get that?
I beg your pardon, I didn't get it anywhere. It's something I need to know for my line of work.
And what might that be?
I'm a cardiologist.
Please go away.
Pardon?
I mean it. Go away. Go bother somebody else. I'm in no mood for this today.
Hey, Jason. Yo, off the swing. Yeah, that's right. I'll come over there. I'll come over there. You want me to come over? Kids looking for a brick in the head.
He's cute.
Yeah.
How old?
I don't know. 5, 6 maybe?
You don't know how old your kid is?
Hey, he's not mine.
Sorry, I didn't.
What do I look like? Come on.
Okay.
I wouldn't have a kid like that. Give me some credit. He's my ward.
your ward?
Well, I'm more like his tutor.
Oh, and what exactly do you teach him?
What do I teach him? I teach him about life. Write down phone messages, don't play with matches, that kind of thing. Sorry I bothered you. I didn't mean to bother you.
Yeah, well.
It's just, you looked in need.
I'm not. So, what exactly is 10K?
Pardon?
10K. What is it?
I think it comes to around 6 miles.
Miles?
It's, you know, metric.
6 miles? I'm gonna kill him.
Who?
Nobody. A friend.
Must be quite the fella.
He's an asshole, you know?
Sure. You want?
No. Yes? What am I doing? What am I doing?
Well, it looks to me like... Jason! Over here! What are you, an idiot? How many times am I gonna tell you? Stop acting like a mongoloid and get off the swing! What? What did you say? Oh, that's right, you said nothing! Let me tell you, that kid's got a mouth like a sewer. I don't know where he gets it from. I'd have that kid horsewhipped. You can't do that though, can you? They're delicate, aren't they? There are all kinds of sociological factors involved. You smack them in the head and next thing you know, they're strolling through Arby's with a high-powered rifle and you're to blame.
Come on.
You think I'm kidding? 9 out of 10 experts will agree with me. Have another hit.
I shouldn't.
What's on the phones?
Oh. Nothing.
It's okay. I'm eclectic. Fred Warren Singers?
No. It's like actual nothing. They're not plugged in, see? You know how sometimes you can't stand to talk to somebody? Well, you know.
Your friend?
It's bad enough he's prancing around in these spandex pajamas, but he's got to keep telling me how wonderful it feels to be alive on a day like this and how he feels this energy, this beautiful energy flowing out of him. He's like a cheap microwave.
Spandex pajamas?
It's his outfit. He's got all these outfits, right? He can never just wear anything. Listen.
Yes?
He gets his body wax. I'm not kidding.
Oh, well.
Not a hair on him. Well, he's from Portugal.
Right.
So there you have it. Oh, your kid's on the monkey bars. Is that okay?
He's not my kid.
Well, you're whatever. Christ, I'm stoned. You're not really a cardiologist.
Not literally, no.
So are you like trying to pick me up or what?
I'm just sitting here.
And you sit here often?
Well, I've got a lot of quality time in my hands. Hey, what'd I say about hanging upside down, huh? Remember Justin Henry?
Who?
That punk from Kramer vs. Kramer? You know where he falls off the jungle gym? I made him watch it, now he wants to be in movies. Are you seriously involved?
Where?
Your Portuguese friend.
We bought a sofa bed together, you know, that counts for something, doesn't it? And we both sleep on it. Oh my God, he loves me. And I can't even listen to him speak without looking for a carving knife. I mean, like, what is going on, you know? What are we doing? We drift into record shops and we wear nice clothes and we eat the Cajun food. And you know, what is all that? You know, what is it? It's garbage. It's absolute. Where is the foundation? Where's the... Listen, I read the papers, okay? He doesn't know it, but the world's coming to an end. The world is coming to an end. We should be getting better, you know, like as a species, like we should be improving, but we're not. The world is coming to an end, and I'm spending my last moments thinking about, ugh, who knows, like skin creams, sugar cones, nonsense. Do you follow?
Yes.
I don't want to help other people. I say that I do, but I don't. I just wish that they would go away. Why doesn't that bother me? I don't know. I don't know.
Great dope, huh?
Yeah.
You ever see It's a Wonderful Life?
No.
Well, it's on TV all the time.
Well, I haven't seen it. It's not a crime.
Okay. Well, Jimmy Stewart wants to kill himself, right? Then this angel, bear with me, this angel comes down and shows what the world would have been like if he never lived. And Jimmy Stewart realizes all the good he's done without even knowing it.
Uh-huh.
Didn't even know it.
So what good have you done?
Well, there you go. I might just be another Mother Teresa. Who can say?
Or you might just be selfish.
Yes, that's another possibility. You know, I'm going to be finished here pretty soon.
How nice for you.
Hmm. Maybe we can get together.
How do you mean?
You know, get together, see what happens. I'm not trying to pick you up.
What are you trying to do?
We could just talk. Would you like to talk? I think we can talk about some things. Listen, I want to talk to you.
What about your ward?
I'll drop him off.
Where?
Where he lives.
And where's that?
Well, it would be interesting, wouldn't it?
Yes, very. But that's not really a reason. Besides, you're married.
No, I'm not.
And you have a kid.
No, I don't.
And I just think you're kind of stoned and bored and... Sorry.
Look at that kid. I swear, he's living with his head up his ass.
Maybe he'll be a proctologist.
Yeah.
I'm Maggie.
Jack. Hello, Maggie.
Hi, Jack.
Hi. All right, Jason, haul it in. Time's up. Hey, did you hear me? I said haul it in. Jason, you get over here prompt or I'm gonna deck you, understand? Daddy's gonna break your little hiney. Jason, I'm gonna count to five. One, two, three, four. Oh. All right, that's it. I'm calling mommy.
Would you like another drink?
Oh, no. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
So why do they do it?
I don't know.
I mean, like these guys with all this, military shit, you know? Zippers everywhere, combat boots, flak jackets. People died in those things. And their heads. They tilt their heads back just a little, you know, looking down at you like, hey, baby, you like this? I mean, don't fuck with me. I'm dangerous. Who are they kidding? Those people, I mean, really dangerous people, don't look like that. They laugh at people like that. Hey, baby. Come on.
Sure.
You see them in the stores, or they're getting their hair cut, and they're going, I want to look like so-and-so, you know? Like a rock star or a killer. Right? Like a killer. Why is that? I mean, why do they want to look like that?
You mean those guys?
Yes.
I don't know.
Do they think it's attractive?
I don't know.
Am I supposed to fall to my knees?
I don't know.
Tell me, do they not see how crude they are?
Probably not.
Really? I don't know. I don't know.
You want another?
No, thanks.
So, what do you do when you're not waiting tables?
How do you mean?
Well, it's not all you do.
Yes, it is.
What do you want to do?
When I grow up?
Yeah.
I am grown up. This is as big as I get. I don't know. I'm taking some classes.
You are?
Over at the Art Students League.
Wow.
Sculpture.
You must be very talented.
Actually, I'm not. Not talented enough.
Maybe I could see your work.
Maybe you could.
I love sculpture. It's very rich, very sensuous, you know, humanistically speaking.
Don?
Yeah.
Don't try so hard, okay?
Would you like another drink?
No.
Come on.
No, it's okay.
One more.
Are you trying to get me drunk?
Of course.
And then what happens?
And then I take you back to my place and show you my flak jacket.
I know that was supposed to be endearing.
I was only just trying to make a joke.
Who gave you the idea that was funny?
I can't seem to say the right things to you.
I'm sorry.
I mean, we were talking before.
I know. Thank you for asking me out. I had a good time, really.
If you really think that I'm just trying to offend you.
Yes. It's all right. Should we go? Don, please, let me take this.
No, I've got it.
I'd like to. You paid for the film.
This is more.
Don, please, don't be silly.
It's covered.
Don, please.
I'm paying for the fucking check, all right? You're my date. I've got plenty of money. Whew. Lisa, I am sorry. I'm sorry. I can't seem to figure you out.
I'm not that complicated.
Well, we're not really hitting it off, are we?
We don't seem to be.
I do like sculpture.
Yeah?
I don't know much about it. I don't know what I'm saying.
Do you enjoy being a man?
It's okay. Do you enjoy being a woman?
Not really.
Would you like to come home with me?
Only if you let me pay the check.
Well, you know it shouldn't be no law. And people that wanna smoke a little dope.
Don! Come here.
What is it?
You gotta see this. Come here, come on.
Oh.
Quiet. Quiet. Look at him.
So?
Look at his eyes.
Oh, man.
What did I tell you?
That is weird. His eyes are open.
It was all the talk at Boys Bunk 12.
You really think he can't see us? How can he sleep like that? I mean...
I know, it's a very disturbing concept.
Yeah, it sure is. Huh.
So, Don, you vicious party beast, what's up next in our parade of pleasure?
I don't know.
twisted sex, substance abuse, senseless acts of violence.
How about we just pack it in?
What?
Well.
You didn't mean that.
That's right. I didn't.
No. What we're going to do is we're going to have a contest.
Why not?
I want you to reach back down deep in that ravaged brain of yours. I want you to think hard and tell me. Three things that happened in the 1970s.
We already did that one, Jack.
We did?
Yeah, we did that one like a month ago.
Oh. Did we enjoy it?
Well, I'm home.
What?
Oh, this is great. He's talking in his sleep.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Bill's really a fascinating guy when he's unconscious. Living next door to him expanded my horizons.
Philip, this is your mother speaking.
Mom?
I have something to tell you. You're not really our son. You're adopted.
Hey, don't do that.
We found you in the hold of a Lebanese freighter.
Jack, leave him alone.
Oh, gosh, Miss Cleaver. Theodore and I were only playing.
You might be doing something to him.
Not Phil. He's got an iron constitution.
You treat him like that when you guys were growing up?
Yes, as a matter of fact.
You ever think he might not like it?
I always assumed he'd be grateful for the attention. I know I would be. Anything on the tube?
I think there's a remote there under the clothes.
You expect me to touch those?
It's clean. I just haven't folded them yet. Hey, don't go throwing things around! It's not in the books.
Clans of the Alpha Moon spaceships. How can you read this stuff?
I like it.
A planet of madmen was the key to Earth's survival.
Jack, come on,
his
put it down.
His efforts to make a sensible
Jack,
equation.
Come on.
Out of the situation.
Jack.
The situation had borne fruit.
You're bending the cover.
Nothing personal, Don, but you're one of the most anal slobs I know.
Thank you.
Mean, it was all right when we lived like that in college. Here we go. Let's see. We got Famine 88. World at War. Whoa. Tits and car crashes on HBO.
I don't get cable.
What? Are you serious?
I'm not paying for a TV.
You gotta get cable. Don, you're really showing your age around here.
Okay, boss.
It's like your tongue.
Working the night
time
shift?
Time to get up.
Working the night shift, huh?
Yeah, guess I said it wrong.
Don, let me ask you something.
Uh-huh.
Every time I come over here, you're always in your underwear.
So?
Well, don't you wear any pants?
I like to be prepared.
For what?
Going to sleep.
Are we hinting at something?
Forget it.
Hey, if you want me to go, don't just sit there in your shorts insinuating. Just tell me. Look me in the eye and say, listen here, Jack, I'm sorry and it's late. I can see that you've got some things on your mind, but I'd rather go to bed than sit here in my ratty underwear listening to you. Be honest, Don. Don't get all ironic for fuck's sakes. Keep me away from irony.
All right, now listen here, Jack.
Yes?
Have another beer.
Thank you.
So, what's on your mind?
Did I say something was on my mind?
You hinted at it ironically.
Don, if you knew anything about me at all, you'd know this. Nothing ever bothers me.
Yeah, you're lucky that way.
Luck's got nothing to do with it. It's a matter of style, image. You've got a problem? Just ask yourself one simple question. What would Ray Charles do in a situation like this? And Ray, I think, hipster that he is.
What problem?
The problem. I don't know. But Ray, badass Ray.
I don't know. Is this my house?
Oh, fucking minor bird in a sport coat here.
What problems?
You heard the latest? This girl, he's been seeing her a week. Every night he goes to her place, right? They talk about the whales or something. He gets to sleep on the couch. She says she's frigid. He says it doesn't matter. She says her uncle raped her when she was 10. He says, I love you. She says, maybe you shouldn't come by anymore. He says, let's give it time. She says, I'm screwing somebody else. He says, it's all right. We can work around it. Isn't that so typical?
Poor guy.
Calls me up, says, Jack, listen. I'm scared to be alone tonight.
When?
This tonight. What am I going to do? A friend's a friend, no matter how you look at it. But I'll tell you something about Phil.
Yeah.
He's a homo.
What?
Gay's a coot.
Are you kidding? He told you?
He didn't tell me. He doesn't even know it.
Then how do you know it?
Don, look at all the women he goes out with. They all eat dog food for breakfast, and they all dump him. That is not normal.
Is this for real?
Look at the facts.
Well, so?
So?
So he's, you know, so what?
Exactly, so what?
I mean, in this day and age.
At this point in time, yes, Don. I know what you're saying, and you're right. Absolutely. Absolutely right.
So what are we arguing?
We're not arguing.
Then what are we discussing?
We're not discussing anything.
Won't your wife be worried?
About what?
Where you are.
Ah. Actually, she's out of town right now.
Is she?
Her bank sent her out there to, out to Ohio. I'm gonna finance another goddamn shopping mall.
She must be doing pretty well. They trust her with that.
Someone's got to put bread on the table.
You guys have a great arrangement.
Oh, I thank Jesus every day.
So, who's taking care of Jason?
He's out there with her.
Out there in Ohio?
It's the kind of place you want to see when you're young.
Sure.
He'll be back pretty soon.
Yeah.
Don, how's your sex life?
Well, you know.
I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
It's fine. I'm seeing this girl.
Well, well.
Yeah.
Well, well, well. Oh, what's she like?
She's, I guess she's kind of serious, you know? Very interesting. We talk a lot.
Oh, I bet.
No, it's, she's always asking me questions. Why I do this, why I say that. We talk about how we feel about things, and I'm learning to be responsible, and, they're okay.
Hmm. Well, I wish you well.
Actually, she may be coming over a little later.
A little later? It's fucking 3 a.m.
She's a waitress over by the park. She finishes at 4.
Sounds pretty devoted.
Well.
So why have you been keeping her a secret?
She's not a secret. She's, you know.
A waitress?
No, she's actually a sculptor.
Does she get paid for it?
Not yet, no.
Well, is she in a museum?
She just started.
So she's a dabbler, right? She's a waitress who dabbles? Nothing to be ashamed of. Why don't you just say that? Does it embarrass you?
No.
Really? Hey, you want to go bowling? That's right. You can.
What did you mean by that?
Bowling, duck pins, sportive kings.
About being a waitress.
Huh? I don't know. That's what she is, right? I didn't mean anything. Do you want to go?
It was insulting, Jack.
I didn't mean it to be.
No, you didn't, but it was, all right? You're always doing this kind of thing.
What am I? What is this about?
You could be a little bit more considerate, all right?
What am I, your therapist?
Jesus, you're doing it again.
What?
You're insulting me.
Oh, come on. Don't be an asshole.
Stop it.
I'm not doing anything, Don. Why are you getting excited? Are you under orders? This is not like you. She's a waitress. She's a sculptress. Fuck do I care? I never even met her.
I feel you really.
You feel? Everybody feels. Fuck that. What are you, a man? Can't you control yourself? You're opening up. You're being sensitive. That's a nice trick, Don, but don't let that go to your head or they'll end up getting yanked around by the wiener, as they say in the vernacular.
I'm not getting yanked around.
I didn't say you were. I merely...
Then take it back.
All right, I hit a sore spot.
You're going to take it back.
Please don't be this
take
way.
Take it back.
All right, Don. Shh. All right. This is childish. Be cool. Be cool. It's me, remember? Not some lady you're trying to bring home. We know each other. We know what we are. We're men, Don. We do terrible things. Let's admit we like them and start from there. You want to be a different person? Get a hug, all the bad thoughts disappear? I'm sorry, it won't work that way. It's not like changing your shirt. You can't promise to do better. That's a lie. Do what you want, Don. Please, be honest. Just do what you want. I beg you, because if you don't, then what kind of man? What are you going to be then? I am your friend, Don. I care about you. Really. I do. Okay? So, you want to go bowling? Hey. I got some Molly. Do you want to do Molly, Don?
All my shoes. Line them up.
What you want, Don? Just think about it. Hmm?
Yeah.
Phil! Wake up. Hey. You want to see something? You'll get a kick out of that. It's up your alley. Jason left that. Go ahead. Read it out loud.
Dear Daddy, Mommy is taking me on Jet. We are going to planet Light Blue. It has a river and some caves called Feeling Caves, a waterfall, beds, and slides. There is a city there called Girls Are For You. I know that is true. I love you, but I think I'm going to stay here. Sounds better than Ohio.
Yeah, right. You know, I read that and I thought, what the fuck does this mean? Is he insane? What's going on in this kid's head? I watch him, right? He's like this tiny guy, really. His shoes are like this big. But something's going on in there. Something is just going on. When he was born, did I tell you?
She's an artist, Jack. Not a waitress, understand?
Yes, Don. Of course. Thank you. I'm glad we could have this little moment together. Only listen. Don't forget who your friends are. Phil!
Uh-huh.
Gotta go.
Go.
Come on.
Oh, I fell asleep.
No kidding.
Man.
Oh, Jesus.
Feel rotten.
Hi. You're early.
You're right.
His legs.
I'm never looking at another woman again.
Very practical.
What's going on?
Some friends came by.
I've done bad things, Jack. So many bad things.
Sorry to disturb you.
Well, don't start.
I only came over here in the middle of the night. Well, you want to introduce us?
Guys, this is Lisa. Lisa, this is Jack, and that's Phil. Phil sleeps with his eyes open.
Young Theodore is afraid of the dark.
Excuse me?
I said he's afraid of the dark.
I thought his name was Phil.
I was making a joke.
Why?
In order to be funny.
Well, so you're the funny one.
Have we met before?
No, but we know who we are.
Can I call you a cab? Jack?
Don tells me you're a very talented sculptress.
I would have destroyed myself for that woman. Gladly. I would have eaten garbage or sliced my wrists open. I mean, not actually, but, you know, if she was just like, hey, Phil, why don't you slice your wrists open? I mean, seriously. We clicked. We connected on so many levels right off the bat. We talked about God for 3 hours once. I don't know what good it did, but man, that intensity. The first time we went to bed together, I didn't even touch her. I didn't want to.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
And, you know, I played it very casually at first because, all right, I've had some rough experiences. I'm the first to admit that. But after a couple weeks, I could feel we were right there. So I laid it down. I told her everything I wanted to, and she says, nobody should ever need another person that badly. I mean, can you believe that? Nobody should ever, I mean, what is that? Is that something you see on TV? Because I dump my heart on the table, and she gives me Dr. Joyce fucking Brothers. Need, I was just saying, I love you. Is that so wrong? Is that not allowed anymore? And so what if I did need her? All right, crucify me. I needed her. So what? I don't want to be by myself. I'm by myself. I feel like I'm going out of my mind. I do. I just sit there and I think there's no way I'm going to make it through the next 10 seconds. I just can't stand it. But I do. Somehow, you make it through, but then you just have to do it all over again because they just keep on coming, all these seconds. You're just floating by while I'm waiting for something to happen. I don't know, a car wreck? A nuclear war? I mean, it sounds terrible, but at least there would be this instant where I'd know I was alive. Just once. Because I look in the mirror, and I can't believe that that's really me. I can't believe that I'm really there. It's like my body is, what, the size of the Statue of Liberty. I'm just inside of it. I'm down in one of the legs. It's like gigantic, hairy leg. I'm just scraping around like some tiny fetus. I don't know who I am, and I don't know where I'm going, and I just wish I'd never been born. And not only that, my hair is falling out, and that really sucks.
You know, Phil, in Cambodia, they don't have time to worry about things like that.
Well, maybe I'll move there.
Well, keep in touch.
Or maybe I'll just kill myself. Huh?
Hey, Phil.
What?
Let me see that smile.
Leave me alone.
Ah, come on.
Why don't you just get away?
Come on, Phil. I see it. I see that smile. Here it comes. Here it comes.
I'm not gonna.
Yes, you are. Just a little. Just a meensy beensy. Just a meensy boinsy. Just a
all right, all right, all right. Aha, aha. I'm smiling. Oh, I'm happy. Oh, I'm so happy. Ha, ha, ha. Jeez, I hate it when you do that.
One day you'll miss me, Phil.
Probably. What? Jason seems to be enjoying himself.
Why wouldn't he be?
I don't know. He just seems glad to be back.
I don't see what you're getting at.
I'm just saying. I'm glad that you and Carla worked it out.
Worked what out?
I don't know. Whatever it was between you.
There's nothing between us, Phil.
Oh, okay.
If there was something between us, we'd sit down and discuss it like reasonable adults. We'd come to an agreement, we'd draw up certain rules, and we'd follow them. Our feelings would never enter into it.
Well, she's a lovely girl, Jack.
She certainly is, Phil. She certainly is. And I'm the luckiest palooka. So, Phil, have you heard from Don lately?
No. What's he up to?
I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
I don't know. He doesn't call me. Why would he call me?
Well, maybe he's trying to get in touch with me.
Wouldn't he just call you then?
Well, maybe he has, but I've been busy, Phil. I don't have time to sit there staring at my phone. I've got things to do. I've got food to eat and records to play. I've got places to go and come back from. I've got miles to go before I go to sleep. All sorts of things. Damn it! Who needs him? Let him play with his dolls. We're having a heck of a time by ourselves, aren't we, little fella? Aren't we?
Sure.
Oh, you bet we are. You bet we are. Hey, Phil, what was the biggest mistake we ever made in our lives?
What?
What?
You were going to say...
Was I? That's our face.
Well, hello.
Miss, I've never seen you before, but... How would you like to be a star?
Jack?
Might be fun.
Fun? Huh. Well, my friend here is too shy to mention it, but he happens to be the associate producer of a new motion picture, and frankly, you've just saved him a trip across the continent. Go ahead. Tell her about the new motion picture. It's a modern picture. It's an American picture. It's the modern story of American men and their modern American women set against a backdrop as modern American as all indoors. It's a spectacle. It's an epic. It's a story of a generation who had it all and couldn't figure out what to do with it. And it's the story of a girl. One special girl. And her quest for meaning in a world she never made. And for the man who wouldn't rest until he tracked her down.
And why would he do that?
Well, he had nothing better to do.
Sounds stupid.
I know. I keep telling him to make a teenage sex farce, but does he listen? Do you listen?
What?
He never listens.
How's your ward?
Discreet as ever.
Good to know.
How's life at the waxworks?
Don't ask me that.
Believe me, I won't.
Mind if I sit?
Oh. Mind if she sits?
Oh, no, I...
we don't mind if you sit.
My name's Phil, by the way.
Hello, Phil.
And this is my friend Jack.
Hi, Jack.
Do you two know each other?
Do we know each other?
We don't know each other.
Oh.
Ever have the feeling you're about to do something you're really gonna regret?
Never.
So, are you doing some running, huh?
It's the right time. She's never hard to please. Oh, no. That girl is pretty wild, no.
Girl's a super freak.
The kind of girl you read about.
Something is coming to get me. I've never seen it, but I know it's there. It thinks about me all the time. And one night I will wake up for no reason, and it'll be there with me. And in that moment, I will know that this is my last minute on Earth. Are you still up?
Yeah.
I have visions. I close my eyes and I see things. There's nothing I can do about it. Like this one time, I closed my eyes and I saw a plane going down over a jungle. And inside there was a boy and a girl and they were just sucking on an orange. And their bodies were being eaten by monkeys. And then there was this other time that I saw an old man sitting on a porch and he just put like pomade in his hair. Well, anyway, he goes, Mike, clean that blade and stick it in the garage. I have no idea what that was all about.
You saw this?
Well, I didn't, like, see it, but I saw it. You know?
So, do you like working in the record store?
I don't work in a record store.
I bought a record from you.
I was only pretending to work there. I do that sometimes. I just walk into a place and pretend I work there.
Why?
I'm mentally ill.
Oh.
Does that disturb you?
It depends.
On what?
If it's true or not.
Well, I used to be a lot worse. When I was 14, I weighed 80 pounds. I didn't eat. I was trying to make myself disappear. Getting rid of my flesh seemed easy. But I couldn't quite figure out how to get rid of the bone. That's the hardest part.
I imagine it would be.
You don't believe me, do you?
I didn't say that.
Well, what would you think if I told you that my father tried to run me over with a steamroller?
Well.
He was a daredevil. There was like six capes in his closet and I was part of the act. See, what he would do is he would tie me up and put me in a laundry bag, and then he would come at me with the steamroller. I had 30 seconds to escape. The trick is, you gotta just, like, completely relax your muscles, and then the cords will just slip right off. Except for when my father would tie double knots.
Why?
He wanted to kill me.
Why would he want to do that?
'Cause he wasn't allowed to fuck me. What's wrong?
Nothing. Excuse me.
Where are you going?
Out. Don't worry. I just have to go. The front door locks itself, so just close it on your way out.
I don't understand. You're leaving?
I think I... There's some high C in the fridge, so you could just help yourself, and we'll talk later.
Have I upset you?
No. No.
Was it something I said?
Look, I'm sorry. It was nice meeting you, but I don't think that you and I should...
Well, don't you like me?
It's not a question of that.
Well, then what did I do wrong?
Nothing. Really.
Please, please, just come here. Look, I know that I'm strange, and I can't help but just... Listen, I can tell fortunes. Did you know that? I can. Would you let me tell your fortune?
What?
Please, just give me your hand. Look, I know that this is upsetting you, and I can't help it. Just give me your hand, and then you can go. Please? Ah, yes. Ah, yes, this is very good. This is nice. Now close your eyes. Clear your mind. Are you relaxed? Nod your head. This is the hand of a man. Very strong, very powerful. This is the hand that will commit great acts. Terrible, but great. It will hurt many people, but it will seldom be raised in anger. It's the hand of a compassionate man. A man with a large soul. Shall I go on?
Sure.
You feel that you have yet to live, that the years are passing you by like a dream. And this is true. But soon, all of that will change. People will flock to you. Men.
Women?
Women, yes. They will be drawn to you, to your power. It cannot be hidden.
And how will I die?
At sea, when you're very old, your body is never found.
All right, you're starting to scare the shit out of me.
Everything will be all right.
Do you work in the record store or not?
It doesn't matter. Come here.
I'm not going to be able to see you again.
Yes.
I shouldn't be doing this. I'm going to get in trouble.
A man can do anything he wants. I'm going to blow out the candle now. Are you going to stay?
Well.
And come to bed.
Are any of the things you told me true?
They're true if you think they're true.
And do you think they're true?
And that's all you have to say about it?
What else do you want me to say?
How about sorry?
Of course I'm sorry. How can I not be sorry?
You haven't said it.
I'm sorry.
No, you're not. I'm going.
What?
What? What? Yeah, what is it?
I just think that you should realize that I've been under a lot of strain recently.
I see.
And, you know, maybe I've handled things badly.
You're under a lot of strain? So you go off and fuck somebody else?
That's unnecessarily blunt.
Christ, you're a cheeky bastard. Could you not even clean up before I came? Put away the odd pair of panties?
I thought they were yours.
I don't buy my panties at job lot, Don. I have a low opinion of people who do.
They keep your ears warm.
You think I'm kidding, don't you? You think, well, Lisa's just having a little episode. It'll all blow over, chalk it up to boyish exuberance and hit the sack? Who the fuck do you think you are? James Bond? Did you use a condom?
Huh?
A condom, Don. You know what they are. You've seen them on TV all the time.
Why?
Because you slept with her. And then you slept with me, and you don't know who she's been fucking, do you, Don? Do you? I'm going.
Where?
I'm going to lie down in traffic, Don. I'm going to let a crosstown bus roll over me because my life is meaningless since you betrayed me. I'm going to my apartment, you stupid shithead.
Lisa, wait. It was just a casual thing. It's over.
What do I care?
I made a mistake. I admit that, but...
But what?
But it made me realize something. Something very important.
Yes?
I love you.
What did you say?
I
heard what you said. You love me? That doesn't mean shit. This isn't high school! You want me to tell you what really counts? Out here with the graduates?
What?
It's not worth it. Do what you want. It doesn't matter to me. I don't even know you, Don. After 4 months, I don't know who you are or why you do what you do. You keep getting your dick caught in things. What is that all about, anyway? Somebody, please explain that to me. Don't look at me that way.
What way?
Like a whipped dog. It's just pathetic.
Lisa, wait. I did something very stupid. It won't happen again.
Do you have any idea what it is you're saying?
I'm saying I feel bad.
I'm sorry, but I feel bad isn't even in the running. Not at all. We're talking about faith. Semper Fidelis. Like the Marines. They don't leave people lying in foxholes. They just do it. You know, they don't feel bad.
How do you know so much about the Marines?
It's not about the Marines, Don. It's got nothing to do with the fucking Marines. It's the idea. You don't understand what I'm talking about, do you? You're just afraid of being punished. I'm not your mother. Oh. I don't spank. I'm going. Have fun fucking your bargain shoppers and cracking jokes with your creepy friends.
Lisa, wait. I have to tell you something.
No, you don't.
I had a dream about you last night.
How inconvenient.
Can I just please tell you this, please, just for a minute?
Start.
Okay. Okay. I was flying in a plane. It was a rocket ship. And I was all alone inside with nothing to eat but boxes of junk food along the rocks in the walls, sandwich creams, raisinettes. Boxes and boxes of crap. The smell was nauseating.
Does this go on much longer?
Anyways, I looked outside, and I could see a tiny planet floating by, like a blue Nerf ball. So I opened a bottle of Yoo-Hoo and sat down to relax. But it must have been dope because it knocked me right out. When I woke up, the cabin was on fire. I couldn't move. I was tied to a chair with piano wire. It was slicing into my wrist like they were chunks of ham. The ship was in a nosedive, and I was slammed against my seat. Suddenly, bam, the whole port side blew away. I could see the planet rolling beneath me. A new world, Lisa. Virgin, pristine, unsullied. And so I reached out, and the whole ship broke up around me in a sheet of flames. I was tied to a chair, falling through a void. My mind had left me. When I came to, I was lying half buried in the sand. My right hand was gone. It was severed at the wrists. Leeches were sucking on the stump. So I rolled over and waited for death. And then you rose from the water on a bed of seaweed. On the white sand, your hips swayed with an animal rhythm. I didn't know why you were there. I didn't ask. So you knelt down beside me, and you gave me nectar from a gourd. You healed me. Right there, under the shade of the trees. You didn't speak. Neither did I. I had forgotten how. So, we built a shelter, and you bore many children, while I caught fish with a spear under the blue light of the three moons. And then, one day, we lay ourselves down in the sand, and the breath eased from our bodies, and we died. And the ocean ate our bones.
What a crock of shit. Do you expect me to believe that?
It's true, I dreamt it.
You've got a vivid imagination, I'll give you that much. Very charming. Very romantic.
It's an omen, a prophecy.
Of what?
Of us. The two of us. Together.
Well, you'd probably make me do the fishing.
I wouldn't. I promise.
Wait. Wait! This is not it. This is nothing. I can't even talk to you until you tell me the truth. Why did you do this, Don? When you knew I trusted you. Was it her breasts? Her buttocks? The smell of her sweat? Was it her underwear? Was it because she wasn't me? Did you have a reason? Any reason at all?
I wanted to see if I can get away with it.
Why?
Because that's what a man would do. Lisa, let's get married. I want to marry you. I want to be faithful to you forever. Can I just lay my head down in your lap? I don't want to think about anything else. Can I just lay my head in your lap? Can we just do that, please?
Would you like to play a little game, Don?
What kind of game?
A pretend game. Let's pretend that you could do anything you wanted, and whatever you did, no one could blame you for it. Not me or anyone else. You'd be totally free. You wouldn't have to make any promises. You wouldn't have to lie. All you would have to do is know how you feel. Just that. How would that be?
I don't know.
Just pretend. What would you do?
I think I would be... different?
Would you?
I'd like to be.
Different how?
Well, I would... I think I would... I think maybe I...
Thank you. Everybody, before you get too comfortable in your chairs, let's work off a little of that delicious roast beef to some of today's yum sounds.
It's so depressing, you know? They remind me of funerals.
Weddings remind you of funerals?
Yes, they remind me of death.
Everything reminds you of death, Phil.
No, it doesn't.
What are you thinking about right now?
Well, death. But that's only because you brought it up.
I didn't bring it up. You brought it up.
No, I didn't.
You said you hate weddings because they remind you of death.
People are drinking those, you know?
Not anymore.
It's so childish, Jack.
Is it?
You don't think so?
Well, yeah.
Why don't you grow up?
You need some more dope. You'll feel better.
I don't want to feel better. Just wish I was dead.
Have you gotten laid lately, Phil?
What's it matter to you?
I like to know my friends are happy.
Well, I think that's incredibly tactless.
Well, I'm sorry you see it that way. So you haven't gotten laid.
He's so curious. Yes, yes, I have gotten laid. Is that okay?
Yes, that's fine.
You have any idea what it's like? You're completely out of it. You've got your wife and your kid. You've got stability. You don't know what it's like to make yourself crawl through the gutter just to get regular sex. When I think of some of the things I've done, it just makes me feel sick.
Like, for instance?
Oh, please.
No, I mean, what things?
I'm not here to provide you with titillation.
Yes, you are, Phil. You just don't know it. Oh, there she goes, the old Earth Mother. Hi, honey. No, we're fine. We're dandy. Yeah. Look at her. She's plastered against the walls. One drink and she's ready for pearl diving without a loincloth. You know, she won't keep booze in the house, you know. She thinks Jason will invite some nursery buddies in for an afternoon mixer. Not to mention she wants the cable disconnected. She thinks he needs more creative playtime. So she buys these toys from Scandinavia. You know what they are? They're unpainted blocks of wood. You're supposed to have fun arranging them. You look at these things and you know why the Swedes keep offing themselves, so I tell
her. If you must know, I fucked a girl while she was unconscious.
Beg your pardon?
You want to know, so I'm telling you.
You fucked a girl while she was
yes.
unconscious?
Yes.
How?
I deserve to die.
I'll decide that, Phil. Just what have you done?
I didn't do anything. She blinked off.
When? Where?
We went out. We went back to her place.
Who is this?
You don't know her.
What does she look like?
You don't know her.
Does she have nice tits? Just tell me about the tits.
That doesn't matter.
Just tell me.
Fine, they were okay.
Only okay.
No, they were fine.
Good, go on.
So, we come back to her place. One of these subdivided closets, you know? And the radiators were howling. It was like a pizza oven in there. So we pour a couple scotches, talk a little bit. Pretty soon I figure out I won't be coming home tonight.
You bound her.
So I get her blouse off.
Wait. How did that happen?
Just, you know, in the course of conversation. You know, it's time to make my move. I take her in my arms.
Uh-huh.
She keels right over. Wham. Right down on the futon.
Jeez.
It was hot in there.
I guess so.
And she did have a lot to drink. Should have seen the liquor tab. Luckily, I was able to charge it, but here I'm thinking, great, isn't this exactly how I wanted to spend my night? I was pretty pissed off.
So you fucked her anyway?
No. Oh. What do you think I am? I decided to put her to bed. I put her to bed, and I'd sleep on the floor and keep an eye on her, so I did that. But she was sweating so much and looked unhealthy, so
You undressed her, right?
I took her shoes off. That's it. I took her shoes off, but then she had these tights on too, so I thought, hey, I better take those off too.
And then you fucked her?
I had her undressed, and I thought, hey, what the hell? I don't want to sleep on the floor tonight. So I got into bed with her, and I don't know. I walked home afterwards, 16 blocks at 3 in the morning, and I was just hoping somebody would kill me. I felt like, you know what's really terrifying? Everyone's afraid of the world getting blown up or something, right? But what if it doesn't? What if it just goes on like this forever? What do we do then?
Oh, you sly old dog.
What?
What an operator, huh? You old dog, you.
I feel awful.
Oh, come on, Phil. Drop the Hamlet routine. Did you speak to her yet?
Yeah, she called me, said she was sorry she fell asleep, and that maybe we could get together again.
And nothing about?
No.
So, everything's okay. You had fun and you covered your ass and no one gets hurt. What's the problem?
Don and Lisa, luck, happiness, and life. This song, it's for you.
What did you get them?
A blender? We had it lying around.
Wish I thought of that. I got them a cheese wheel.
A what?
You know, a cheese wheel, a wheel of cheese. Comes in the mail.
Uh-huh.
It's Jarlsberg. People like Jarlsberg, don't they?
I couldn't say, Phil. I know a lot of things, but I don't know that.
Well, what the hell? It's not like I see him every day. You catch the bride?
Yeah. She's a real Bowser, huh?
Jack.
What?
That's so rude.
Would you say that girl's attractive?
Just your attitude towards women.
Hey, I don't have an attitude towards women. I'm not questioning her right to exist. I'm simply asking if you find her attractive.
Well, no, I don't.
Well, then why are you getting upset?
Oh, maybe he loves her. Did that ever occur to you?
Of course it occurred to me. But that's not going to make her any better looking now, is it, Phil? So don't give me that attitude bullshit. I'm just telling the truth. No one's going to punish you for telling the truth.
Hey, don't do that.
I'm
Jesus.
Just kidding. So, Phil, you're still working at that place, aren't you?
Unfortunately.
9 to 5?
Uh-huh.
I need you to do me a favor.
Like what?
Like letting me use your apartment during the daytime.
Sure. Why not? How come?
I need to be able to be alone in the afternoons.
What's wrong with your apartment?
It's no good.
Why's that?
Why do you think?
I don't know.
You don't have to know. You just have to do me a favor.
I mean, it's my apartment, Jack. I'd like to know what it's being used for.
All right, fine. Don't do it. Jesus.
Hey, I mean, I trust you, but...
You're my friend?
Sure.
Then I need your help. I've got to meet somebody, and I can't do it at my place.
A woman?
Yes, she is a woman.
I see.
You'll appreciate the difficulty.
Right.
So you'll do it?
Don't,
Phil, come on. I do it for you.
I mean, but that's different, right? I'm single. I'm supposed to be doing stuff like that. You're talking about adultery.
Oh, please.
I mean, you and another woman? I don't know.
Let's not get melodramatic, Phil. This has nothing to do with adultery. This is just a nice little affair I'm going to allow myself to have. A quick tour of foreign panties, and then it's back to the bus home. Everybody's happy and no one gets hurt. What could be simpler?
I don't think I can do it. I'd feel too guilty. I'd be helping you ruin your life.
You're joking, right?
I mean, have you told this girl you're married?
I've implied as such.
But you haven't told her.
Why am I having this discussion?
You're so big on the truth. Oh. Why haven't you told her?
Oh, well, we're up on our little throne, aren't we? Huh, you and your fucking sexual sob stories. You think you know the truth?
Yes, I do.
No, you don't. Absolutely not. You want to know the truth? You want to know what I found out while you sit there twisting your guilt-ridden nuts off? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what you do, Phil, because nobody is watching. Nobody is taking notes. Nobody is heating up a pitchfork. There is nobody there. So don't dare tell me that I'm doing something wrong because I decide that, and I decide that there is nothing wrong. I'm going to commit adultery, Phil. I'm actually going against the Ten Commandments, and as long as I'm careful and I don't get caught, I don't give a shit. Nothing's happening, Phil. Where is the lightning?
We can't go on meeting like this.
Oh, there he is, the man of the minute.
You two look like a couple of derelicts. How you doing, Philly?
Okay, just great.
Put her there, Don. Big Don, big old Don.
Why am I Big Don?
Because you are. You look like a waiter. Here you go.
Is this for real?
You can smoke some now and sublet the rest.
Yeah, well, congratulations, Don. I'm really happy for you.
Don't get maudlin, Phil.
You guys having a good time?
You bet. I love eating next to the men's room.
Look, I'm sorry about that.
Hey, hey, doesn't bother me.
See, Lisa, I don't know. She did the seating.
No need to apologize, Big Don. I'm sure you had more important things on your mind.
Well, yeah.
You couldn't be expected to be bothered with these little details.
I didn't look too stupid, did I?
No, not too stupid.
Did you guys notice when my collar button popped off?
Actually, Big Don, I did not notice that. Actually, I missed most of the wedding. Lovely as I know it must have been. Actually, since I was not part of the wedding party, that is, the wedding party per se, I didn't actually think it was important
well,
for
hey,
me to...
Well, hey, this is just a lovely reception. You know, it's... I love it. It's the music. It's well, great.
Yeah, Lisa's parents, you know, they wanted a big thing.
Oh,
so.
And they're definitely getting a big thing, eh, Big Don? Yep. So, Donnarooney, this is the day for you, huh? Tying that wacky old knot, strolling down that... goofy aisle of matrimony, setting down to a big heap of domestic bliss.
Well, I hope so.
You're going to love it, kid. Take it from me, be fruitful and multiply.
She's a lovely girl, Don.
Huh?
Lisa?
Oh, thanks.
Big Don, let me ask you a question.
Shoot.
You and the little woman, you're off on a honeymoon, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
So what's happening with your apartment while you're away?
My folks are staying there.
Well, isn't that thoughtful?
Did you...
Me? Oh, don't concern yourself with me.
Hey, well, it's hard to believe.
What?
Just, you know, that we're here, all three of us. I mean, we've known each other all these years. And, you know, when we were younger, we didn't know what were going to happen or what we're going to do. Now we're older. And you've got a kid. You're getting married. Just think.
It's not that difficult of a concept, Phil.
I hope you and Lisa will be very happy together, Don.
I don't see why not.
You could always get a divorce. What'd I say?
They just got married, Jack.
I'm aware of that. I'm just saying it's an option. It's something to take into account. Right, Big Don?
I suppose it's always a possibility.
You see? It's a possibility. You want to smoke that reefer now?
You have it. I'm really not supposed to.
Oh?
I sort of promised myself it's no big deal.
No, certainly not.
Something I've been wanting to do.
By all means.
Anyways, they're just as bad as cigarettes, so...
Yet another significant consideration. When did you learn to tie your shoes?
I'm wearing slip-ons.
Ah, the bedrock of a lasting marriage.
Fuck you, Jack.
Does that mean you don't love me anymore?
Not if you're gonna talk like that.
Well, I thought we were discussing footwear.
Jack, I'm sorry.
About what?
I don't know.
Then why did you say it?
I don't know. I thought... I don't know. I'm just sorry.
You know what I always liked about you, Don? You're always so fucking eager to please. It's really pathetic. In a zany kind of way.
I better go. I have to wheel my aunt around.
Go get her, cowboy.
Listen, I'm glad you guys came. I am. When I get back?
You bet.
Great.
Okay. Rest easy.
Don, a living dead.
Huh?
Guy's walking around like a fucking zombie.
I mean, he looked all right to me.
Did he? Did he now?
Yeah, he looked happy.
Phil, I hate to be one to break this to you, but you're hopelessly out of date. Happiness? That's the 60s. Peace marches, paisley trousers. This is the modern world. It's kind of young, kind of kooky. It's kind of
Why don't you just shut the fuck up? I'm sick of you and your miserable, sarcastic bullshit. I'm going to go dance the Hokey Pokey.
No, Phil!
Don't say it!
No, Phil, wait! Come here! Come. Look at me. Come on.
What?
This is bad. This is all wrong. I mean, I'm kidding. Does anybody know I'm kidding? Look at me. Do I look serious?
No.
No, of course not. Now, how long have we known each other?
Long time.
Since we were midgets, Phil. And, all right, we've had our differences, our points of view, but basically...
Yeah?
Basically, we're friends. Yes, you and me, friends.
We're friends.
That's right, we are. And we're not going to forget that because of a little... I'm not. I swear, I'm not. I know what's right, Phil. I do, and I know what's wrong. And so... Don't be mad at me, okay?
I'm not mad at you.
You're not? Oh, I knew it. I love you, you big hunk. Oh. So, can I have the apartment? Phil? Hey, Phil! Phil! What? What is that supposed to be, an answer? I'm talking to you, Phil! Oh, yeah? Well, fuck you! I will make my arrangements! And you know nothing! Live with that, you fucking child!
Howdy, stranger.
Hi.
Guess what?
What?
I'm having a good time.
Oh.
Are you having a good time? Mm. Ah, the silent type. I like that in a fella. Wanna get married?
Sure.
I'm a little drunk.
No.
I'm just gonna rest my eyes for a minute.
You do that.
I will. Did I tell you how nice you look tonight?
No.
Well, I'm gonna. I was sitting there watching you thinking how nice he can look. Why does he look so nice?
We should get going.
Mm-hmm.
No, the sitter is waiting.
Home, home. Home with you. Know what I'm thinking?
Uh-uh.
You're not the worst man in the world.
I'm not, huh?
No. I'm afraid you're just not. But you'd like to be.
This is calm, it's gonna get you. Gonna knock you right on the head.
You better get yourself together. Pretty soon you're gonna be dead. Why in the world are you thinking of laughing in the face of love? What on earth are you trying to do? It's up to you. Yeah, you.
This ain't a song for the broken hearted. When I shout it out loud, it's my life, it's now or never. I ain't gonna live forever. I just wanna live when I'm alive. It's my life, my heart is like an open highway. Like Franken said, I did it my way. I just wanna. Stood their ground.